Hello, and welcome to Palm Sunday Worship with St. Paul's United Methodist Church of Mendota Heights, Minnesota. Today, we celebrate the beginning of Holy Week as we remember how crowds greeted Jesus as he came into Jerusalem, shouting Hosanna and waving palm branches in celebration of his Lordship. Before we begin our Palm Sunday worship service today, I have just a few words of announcement to share with you. On Thursday, April 14th, at 7 o'clock p.m., we will have a Maundy-Thursday worship service at St. Paul's United Methodist Church. At this service, we will remember the giving of the Great Commandment and the institution of the Lord's Supper, and we'll share communion together. On Friday, April 15th, we will have a service of worship also at 7 o'clock p.m. in remembrance of Good Friday. This somber worship service will focus on prayers, scripture readings, and meditations on each of the stations of the cross. Then, on Sunday, April 17th, we'll gather together at 10:30 a.m. for Easter worship in celebration of the resurrection of Christ. Looking ahead beyond Easter, the United Methodist Women will have a spring rummage sale on Saturday, April 23rd, from 9 o'clock until 3 o'clock. And mark your calendar for Sunday, May 1st. On that day, we'll celebrate the renovations to our sanctuary space with worship at 10:30 and music and snacks at 11:30. We hope you'll be able to join us on this day as we celebrate the refresh of our sanctuary area. And now, let us lift our hearts towards God, raise our praises on this Palm Sunday, and begin our worship service with prayer.
Almighty God, when your son Jesus came to Jerusalem, crowds waved palm branches to celebrate. Let us join their phrases today, proclaiming that Christ is King and following Jesus in the way that leads to new life. Amen.
Hey, boys and girls, welcome. Today's a very, very special day. It's called Palm Sunday. Yay. Lorraine, do you know what Palm Sunday is?
I think so, Wendell. Isn't Palm Sunday when all the people greeted Jesus coming into Jerusalem with a parade, and they waved palm branches, and they sang praises to God, and they shouted, Hosanna, and hallelujah, and praise the Lord?
That's exactly right. Well, we get a chance to do that today, too, with a song called Hallelujah, 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 Praise Ye the Lord. Now, I'm going to sing the hallelujah part, and Lorraine, you get to sing the Praise Ye the Lord part.
Praise Ye the Lord.
Yep, that's right, that's right. Well, kids, join us. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise ye the Lord. Great, great. Lorraine, I'd like to do it one more time.
Let's do it again.
How about you start the hallelujah part? I'll do the praise ye the Lord.
Okay. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord. Lord. Great. Bye-bye.
Good morning. Today we are reading the story called Palm Sunday out of our Spark Story Bible. Palm Sunday. Friends, Jesus said to his disciples, I need to go to Jerusalem. I've got some important things to do, and I want to celebrate Passover with you there. Will you come with me? Sure, said the disciples. Passover is a great holiday, such good food, and what a wonderful story Passover celebrates. The exodus of God's people, the Israelites, from Egypt. It's good to be with friends and family at Passover. So Jesus and his friends started to go to Jerusalem. When they got close to the city, Jesus said, I'd like two of you to go borrow a donkey in the next village over. Please tell the owner I need it. He'll understand. When the two friends came back with a donkey, Jesus climbed on its back and rode down the hill into the city of Jerusalem. The disciples followed behind him. Suddenly, they found themselves in a parade. People were singing and shouting, Hosanna! Hosanna! Here comes God's King! Hosanna! Praise God! People all over heard the shouting and singing, and they joined the parade too. Hundreds of people, thousands of people. They started taking off their coats and laying them on the ground for Jesus and the donkey to walk on. They pulled palm branches down from the trees and waved them as they sang. Then they threw their palms on the ground to make a path for Jesus. The crowds gave Jesus a royal welcome as he rode into the city, just like a king. But Jesus was a very different king. He was a king of peace. Not everyone understood that. Jesus was not at all what they were expecting. They thought the crowd was too loud and the parade was getting too big. Who is that man? Someone asked. What's going on here? Asked another. The crowd answered, This is Jesus, God's King. He has come to save us. Some of the religious leaders murmured, Hush. Jesus, tell your friends to be quiet. It's way too loud here. But Jesus said, We can try to make these people be quiet, but that wouldn't make a difference because today the whole earth is celebrating.
Of children made sweet hosannas ring. The people of the Hebrews with palms before thee went. A prayer and praise and anthems before thee we present.
A gospel reading from Luke 19, verses 28 through 40. After he had said this, he went on ahead, going up to Jerusalem. When he had come near Bethphage and Bethany, at the place called the Mount of Olives, he said to two of the disciples, saying, "Go into the village ahead of you, and as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you why are you untying it, just say this, 'The Lord needs it.'" So those who were sent departed and found it as he had told them. As they were untying the colt, its owners asked them, "Why are you untying the colt?" They said, "The Lord needs it." Then they brought it to Jesus, and after throwing their cloaks on the colt, they set Jesus on it. As he rode along, people kept spreading their cloaks on the road. As he was now approaching the path down from the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to praise God joyfully with a loud voice for all the deeds of power they had seen, saying, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest heaven." Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to him, "Teacher, order your disciples to stop." He answered, "I tell you, if these were silent, the stones would shout out." This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. When the crowds gathered to wave palm branches and shout Hosanna on Palm Sunday, they were very publicly making a statement about the lordship of Jesus Christ in their lives. In doing so, they set an example for us today on how to exuberantly and publicly share our faith. This is how good evangelism can happen. When we notice that the way that God's Spirit is working in our lives and share our hallelujah moments with others. Now, if you remember from Methodist history, early Methodists in the United States were considered to be enthusiasts by people of other faith traditions. But in their enthusiasm, they really did share their faith passionately. And I hope that we are continuing to do that today. So I ask you, how is God at work in your life right now? And what hallelujah moments do you have to share? Here's some of the ways that I've seen God at work in the lives of the people of our congregation at St. Paul's. These are just a few examples. And let's start with the kindness quilt. Do you remember the kindness quilt that our children and youth put together? Each of them submitting a piece of artwork that showed them engaging in an act of kindness. And as we put all the pieces together, we developed a whole quilt full of kindness. Well, that kindness quilt has helped some of our people to focus on kindness and loving their neighbor. And so as a result, kindness and love of neighbor has grown. That's a hallelujah for me. On a much more serious note and situation, when the war began suddenly in the Ukraine, there was much media coverage of all of the acts of violence. It was very unsettling for people around the world to see what was happening and what was unfolding. In the midst of that turmoil, God's peace helped us to remain calm. God's hope kept us from despair. And as Christians, we knew what to do. We prayed for peace. We prayed for protection for people in the areas of violence. And we started working to care for and help the refugees because we knew it was always the role of God's people to care for and love our neighbor. So in the midst of this great difficulty, God provided us with hope, strength, and resolve to act as God's people and share God's love. Now, God provides hope and strength in many situations. For people who are experiencing recovery from addiction as part of their spiritual walk, God has given strength, hope, and guidance, resulting in one more day of sobriety, one more day of clean time, freedom from the bondage of addiction, and transformation to new life. The difference this makes is remarkable. You may remember only just a month or two ago, a new climate change report was announced, and it had some very concerning things in it. When this hit the news, many people were despondent. But God has made us a hopeful people, prevented us from despairing and calling us to help. I think that's why people enjoyed sharing their green habits with each other so much. It was a way that we could show our hope and how, as people of faith, we could help. Now, in our lives, we experience both joys and sorrows. And when we experience the grief that comes from losing a loved one to death, it can really, really make our hearts ache. But in the midst of our sorrow, God provides for people of faith the hope of the resurrection, the hope of eternal life, and the comfort of church family. It has been a blessing to me to see the hope of the resurrection come alive even amidst grief, to bring us hope, knowing that death is not the end, but resurrection is the beginning. How about you? What are your hallelujah moments? And with whom will you share them? Someone needs your witness today. So I say to you, share your hallelujah.
Please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Has God blessed you since last Holy Week? Then let's raise our voices to God in prayer, saying, thank you, God, and hallelujah.
Has God blessed you by sending you wisdom when you needed guidance?
Thank you, God, and hallelujah.
Has God blessed you with peace during a time when you were anxious?
Thank you, God, and hallelujah.
Has God blessed you or someone you love with another day of clean time or sobriety during your recovery?
Thank you, God, and hallelujah.
Has God blessed you with a loving community or a new friend when you felt alone?
Thank you, God, and hallelujah.
Has God blessed you by sending joy or sunshine into your life on a day when everything looked down and rainy?
Thank you, God, and hallelujah.
Has God blessed you with a Savior, a resurrection, and new and abundant life?
Thank you, God, and hallelujah.
And all of God's people said,
hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
As we begin Holy Week, I want to say thank you to those who are already sending in your contributions for this year's Easter offering. This year's Easter offering will be designated 25% towards emergency humanitarian relief in and around the Ukraine through the United Methodist Committee on Relief, UMCOR. 25% of this year's Easter offering will be designated towards hunger alleviation through the service work of our youth group in our own community. And 50% of this year's Easter offering will go towards the general fund of St. Paul's United Methodist Church. Thank you for your generosity. It touches the lives of others and brings forward the mission of the church. You can give by using your smartphone with the Vanco Mobile Faith Engagement app or by mailing in checks to the church office. And now, let's bless these gifts which have been received with a prayer of thanksgiving.
All of my treasures I joyfully give, the prayers that I whisper, the life that I live, my time and my talent, my hands and my heart. God gave all this to me. Now I'll do my part. Amen.
Praise God from whom our blessings flow. Praise God, our creatures here below.
We come now to the table of Holy Communion. All are welcome to come to this table who wish to live in peace and reconciliation with God and with their neighbor. It doesn't matter if you're a member of this church or of any church. If God is speaking to your heart today and calling you to participate in this holy ritual, then please come and join us today at the table of grace. The prayer of consecration, which I pray today, extends not only to the bread and juice here with me in the video, but also to the bread and juice which you hold in your hand. And so, let us pray. Almighty God, we give thanks to you for your many blessings. You are our source of life and being, and we thank you for the life breath that we draw that comes from you. We thank you for your breath of life that flows through all of creation. And especially, we thank you today for wheat and grapes that come to us on our communion table as bread and juice. We give thanks to you for your love and mercy, which know no end, and for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, who came to be our Savior. Today, we remember how he came into Jerusalem, and the people waved palm branches and shouted Hosanna, proclaiming him their King and their Lord. And then only a few days later, Jesus would gather with his disciples in an upper room, take bread and cup, give thanks to you, bless them, and say, "Take, eat. This is my body and my blood poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you do this, do it in remembrance of me." And so we come to this table in remembrance of that day and ask you to pour out your Holy Spirit on these gifts of bread and juice. Make them be for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, that we might be fed by your very hand, renewed in spirit, and sent out in ministry to all the world. All of this we pray in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The body of Christ, broken for you and for me, for forgiveness of sins. The blood of Christ, shed for you and for me. Amen. We give thanks for this holy gift of communion. May God bless us as we receive this sacrament. Amen.
And now may the love of God fill our hearts. May the wisdom of God fill our minds. May the encouragement of God be in our words. May the hope of God lift up our souls. Amen.